बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। आई एम प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर सैयदा अज़रा कमर, प्रोफेसर ऑफ जोलॉजी, हेड ऑफ जोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट, इंचार्ज फैकल्टी ऑफ साइंस, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज फॉर वीमेन, शाहराह लियाकत, कराची। टॉपिक इज बाइटिंग अपरेटस एंड बाइटिंग मैकेनिज्म इन स्नैक्स। इट इज़ फॉर बीएससी पार्ट टू, पेपर थ्री। First, I discussed on snacks. Snacks are elongated, limbless and carnivorous reptiles. Like all other squamates, snacks are ectothermic amniote. What does amniote means? Amniote is found in higher vertebrate. These are the protective membrane which is found inside the eggshell. So it is called amnion, and the animal is called amniota or amniote. Snakes can be found on every continent except Antarctica. The body of snakes is covered with epidermal overlapping scales. They bear well-formed biting apparatus coupled with toxic venoms produced by the poison gland. About 300 species may be harmful to human. There are two types of the snakes are present: poisonous snakes and non-poisonous snake. The poisonous snakes are bright in color. Their head are triangular in shape. The fangs are present. Eyes are vertical in position. Cat eye slits for pupils. Anal plate in a single row. Bite mark is a fang marks. Example: saw-scaled viper, king cobra, and tiger snake. Non-poisonous snakes, they do not have bright color. Head is narrow and elongated. Fangs are not present. Pupils are rounded. Anal plate in a double row. Bite mark is a small teeth in a row. Example is a family, Boidae, etc. These are poisonous apparatus in snakes. This is a poisonous gland. It has a venom. This is a duct. This is a fang sheath and fang. And these are maxillary teeth. Poisonous apparatus in snakes. The poison apparatus of snakes consists of a pair of poison glands, their ducts, and a pair of fangs. Poisonous gland. Each poison gland is a sac-like and provided with a narrow duct. They are modified superior labial or parotid glands located on the either side of the upper jaw, thickly encapsulated with fibrous tissue sac, and passes forward along the side of the upper jaw and loop over itself just in front of the fangs. Capsule send vascular fibrous septa that separate the glandular substance into secretory pockets. The second apparatus is called fang, and fangs are sharp and large maxillary teeth positioned along the upper jaw at the front or rear of a snake's mouth and connected to venom glands. Fangs are long, sharply pointed and hook-like, being extremely hard and calcified with a superficial enamel layer. That means the fangs is covered with the outer layer, which is called enamel layer. Snakes eject venoms by their two hollow teeth, which is called fangs. These are the poisonous gland. These are muscles, tongue, poisonous fang, pit, and the nostril. Types of fangs. Two types of the fangs are present: open type and closed type. Open type furrows by a grooves for the conduction of the venom, and the closed type fangs become almost or hypodermic syringe like structure due to approximation of the groove tips. According to the structural differences, poison glands are of three types: opisthoglyphous, proterogyphous, Solenoglyphus and aglyphus. Glyphus is a Greek word which means groove. These are the structural differences of the poison fangs. Opisthoglyphus, grooved fangs lie at the back of the maxilla. This is maxilla and this is the back of the maxilla, behind the normal teeth, and are of open category. Example is some colubrid snakes. Number two type is a proteroglyphus. In this type, fangs are situated at the front end of the maxilla and are of close category. Example is cobra and sea snake. Number three is a solenoglyphus. Fangs are movable and turned inside. Example is viper and rattlesnakes. And the last one is aglyphus. Aglyphus snakes, or the types of fangs found in the snakes, are unmodified teeth, essentially non-fangs. All snakes, even those that possess fangs of the first three type, have aglyphous teeth, which they use for gripping their prey as they manipulate during swallowing. This species has enlarged posterior maxillary teeth that lack of grooves. Examples are python and boa. These are the types of muscles which are associated with the fang for biting mechanism. There are three types of the muscles that take part in biting mechanism: digastric muscles, sphenopterygoid muscles, and the anterior and posterior temporalis muscles. Digastric muscles attached to the squamosal of skull at one end and the articular of the lower jaw. It helps in the opening of the jaws. Second type is the sphenopterygoid muscles. Sphenopterygoid muscles, these muscles are also called protector muscles or pterygoid muscles, attached anteriorly to the sphenoid region and the at the posterior, it attaches with the dorsal surface of the pterygoid. It assists in dragging the pterygoid forward. Third type is the anterior and the posterior temporalis muscles. These muscles attach to the side wall of the cranium and the lower jaw. They help in closing the lower jaw. These are the types of venom. There are four distinct types of the venom: proteolytic venom, hemotoxic venom, neurotoxic venom, and the cytotoxic venom. Proteolytic venom, it found at the molecular surrounding including the bite. Hemotoxic venom, it acts on the heart and the cardiovascular system. Neurotoxic venom, it acts on the nervous system and the brain. Cytotoxic venom, it has a localized action at the site of the bite. Two main types of the venom. These are the main or the important type of the venom, which is called hemotoxic and neurotoxic. Hemotoxic venom destroys the red blood cell and causes the hemolysis, interrupt blood clotting, and also attacks other cells and tissues, causing throughout the tissues damage and often organ failure. Bites are very painful. Symptoms are not appear for hours after a bite. Bleed from orifice like nose, eyes, and also gums and the brain. The second is a neurotoxic venom. It attacks on the nerves and nervous system. Little pain following by swelling. Paralyzation or penalization of the body followed by the death from respiratory failure. Symptoms include droopy eyelids, double vision. There is sometimes excess salivation and vomiting. the chemical composition of the venom. The normal function of a snake venom is to immobilize the prey or the victim and to assist in digestion. The toxic component of snake venom can be classified into four broad categories: enzyme, polypeptides, glycoprotein, compounds of low molecular weight classified as protein 90 to 95%, and non-protein. These are the biting mechanism with biting apparatus. These are the poisonous gland located behind the eyes. These are the duct and these are the fangs. The poisonous gland is full of venom. At the time of biting, the venom goes inside the duct to the fangs. Biting mechanism is very complicated process based on four steps: opening of the mouth, rotation of maxilla, transfer of venom, and the closing of the mouth. Number one is the opening of the mouth. The mouth is opened by the action of the contraction of digastric muscles. Rotation of maxilla. After the opening of the mouth, the lower jaw moves forward. Rotation of squamosal, quadrate, and mandibles occurs. At that time, sphenopterygoid muscles start to contract. Due to the contraction of the sphenopterygoid muscle, results in the forward movement of pterygoid and up pushing of the ectopterygoid. Then ectopterygoid allows the maxilla to rotate along its axis. As a result, fang is elevate and take striking position. Then the forward action of the pterygoid is communicated to the maxilla and causes it to rotate through about 90 degree. Fang is raised and becomes directed forward. The contraction of sphenopterygoid muscles also helps in the movement to carry out the pterygoid forward. These are partially open mouth. This is the whole mouth open and the fangs are erect through the action of the maxilla. Next is the transfer of venom. Contraction of the digastric muscles will press the poisonous gland. The poison to come out of the poisonous gland and flow into the victim. The last one, the closing of mouth. This is brought about by the contraction of the temporalis muscles and sphenopterygoid muscles. The fang is directed backward while the mouth is closed. It takes longer time to open the mouth than to close it. This is the first aid. Call medical help immediately if possible. Remove any rings, bracelet or watches. Loosen any tight clothing in case swelling occurs. Chest movement, as breathing will be affected by this. If there is no bandage or equivalent to apply a pressure bandage, lie down and keep the bitten part at the body level. Do not take aspirin because aspirin dilutes the blood or other pain relievers. Do not try to suck the venom out of the wound. Do not raise the wound above the heart. Raising it can cause venom to travel into the body. Holding down can increase swelling. Do not wash the snake bite area. Do not try and capture the snake. Thank you.